Вы слушаете SBS Russian.
Вы слушаете SBS Russian. Мы отдаем дань уважения традиционным владельцам земли, их старейшинам прошлого и настоящего. Приветствуем вас в очередном выпуске нашей постоянной рубрики Learn English. Для тех, кто учит английский язык, хочет совершенствовать свой английский и особенно его австралийский вариант.
Learning English helps me talk about all the things that annoy me.
Hello everyone, it's Gloria again. So, when I first heard of the expression pet peeve, I thought people were talking about their pets. You know, very cute and lovely animals. But nope, it's the opposite. A peeve is something that annoys you. Adding pet just shows that it is specific to a person. It might be something that one person finds annoying but someone else thinks is okay. For example, one of my pet peeves is people making loud noises and talking when I'm trying to watch a movie in the cinema. I love movies, and I just find it so frustrating when people won't let me enjoy the movie properly. I didn't pay to go to the movies to hear other people talking, so it makes me very cranky when they do, because I can't focus on the movie. Cranky means irritated or annoyed, not quite angry. I also get cranky when I'm hungry, but that's another story. But it's not just me. Everyone has pet peeves, right? In this lesson, you will learn how to talk about the things that annoy you, and maybe you'll be less cranky after talking about it. First, let's listen to the dialogue. Alan and Claire are talking about their pet peeves over lunch. Let's hear what they have to say.
Oh no! How do people just forget to screw the lid back onto the sauce bottle properly? It's so annoying! Now the sauce is all over my pants and the floor.
And you just don't notice until it's too late, right?
Yeah, it really gets under my skin when people do that. That's one of my biggest pet peeves.
I feel ya. Hey, do you know what really bugs me? It's when some...
Wait, actually, when someone chews their food very loudly, that is so annoying.
Really? Stuff like that doesn't bother me. But do you know what really drives me up the wall?
Do tell.
When someone jumps in and starts talking over me when I'm trying to say something.
Oops. I guess Alan just couldn't help himself. That means he was so excited that he did something he shouldn't do. He talked over Claire. He just really wanted to say what was on his mind. I get it. I understand. But I agree with Claire. It's one of my pet peeves too. I also understand how Alan felt when the sauce went all over him. The other day, I broke the lid off a bottle of sauce when I was opening the fridge. And it went everywhere on the floor and my jeans, just like Alan. So I agree with him when he says...
It's so annoying.
What things annoy you? Another thing that I find really annoying is when people talk loudly on their phones next to me when I'm having a meal in a restaurant. Why can't they speak elsewhere? Just like Claire, I could say...
Yeah, it really gets under my skin when people do that.
You can say that something gets under my skin to talk about something that always bothers you. For example, when puppies keep licking not just my hands but also my toes, I get so annoyed because I don't know how to make them stop. Now, that really is a pet peeve because it's a peeve and it is caused by a pet. Get it? Okay, not the best joke. Anyway, Claire shows that she understands how Alan feels by saying,
I feel ya.
I feel ya is short for I feel you. It's an informal way to show you understand and agree with someone, particularly if they're complaining about something. Claire then says,
Do you know what really bugs me?
Just like bugs or insects that might annoy you by buzzing around your head, when something or someone bugs you, it means they irritate or bother you. If you want to use a stronger phrase for something more extreme, you can say what Claire did.
Do you know what really drives me up the wall?
If something drives you up the wall, it is so annoying that you feel like climbing the walls to get away from it. Drives can also be used with phrases like drives me crazy or drives me mad. Generally, is used with negative emotions. Now that we have had a look at some words and phrases we can use to talk about our pet peeves, let's listen to the dialogue again.
Oh no! How do people just forget to screw the lid back onto the sauce bottle properly? It's so annoying! Now the sauce is all over my pants and the floor.
And you just don't notice until it's too late, right?
Yeah, it really gets under my skin when people do that. That's one of my biggest pet peeves.
I feel ya. Hey, do you know what really bugs me? It's when some...
Wait, actually, when someone chews their food very loudly. That is so annoying.
Really? Stuff like that doesn't bother me. But do you know what really drives me up the wall?
Do tell.
When someone jumps in and starts talking over me when I'm trying to say something.
So today, we're not just in the studio, we're outside on the streets. Came out here just to try to ask around and see what does the public think of the phrase pet peeve. So, have you ever heard of the phrase pet peeve before?
Yes.
Yep.
If you don't know the phrase pet peeve, what would you think of when you hear about it, like pet peeve?
A dog peeing. 100% a dog peeing.
I have no idea. I think when I first heard it, I was like, well, has it got something to do with animals, maybe?
Is it? What is that again?
Pet peeve.
No, I haven't heard of that.
Okay, that's fair.
What's your biggest pet peeves?
People acting too dramatic.
Mm.
Yeah, that's a peeve. Yeah. It annoys me. I don't like drama.
I guess people taking off their shoes in the train or in the public transport, probably.
Or maybe people not lining up while taking the public transport. Yeah.
I have a lot of pet peeves. People that are loud in public and ignorant of other people. People that litter and throw their rubbish out.
I think of my own personal pet peeves. One of those would be when you're walking behind a group of people who are really slow and they're taking up the whole sidewalk and you're trying to see where you can get an in to walk around and they're just not very aware.
Stupid questions. Just
work-related.
Yeah, work-related. It's just questions which are easily researched, but they just too lazy to actually do it.
I hope this is not...
No, it's not a stupid question. It's an interesting question. It's just things that are easily thought about and answerable, but then they don't. They just want someone else to answer the question for them.
That is probably your biggest one.
My biggest one would be, we've got like, you know, when with my sister, right, when there's a very easy task she could do and she just chooses to avoid it. Like the dishwasher's right there, but she just puts the dishes above and then you have got to put them in. It's like the smallest thing, but it's quite annoying, you know.
It's time to practice. See if you remember the meaning before hearing the answer. If someone said something bugs them, what does it mean? It means something irritate or bother them. How about cranky? Cranky means grumpy or easily annoyed. Now, let's practice some of the phrases by repeating after Alan and Claire.
It really gets under my skin when people do that.
I feel ya.
That's one of my biggest pet peeves.
Do you know what really bugs me? Do you know what really drives me up the wall?
We've got learning notes and a full transcript on our website, sbs.com.au/learnenglish. Also, feel free to find us on Facebook. We are SBS Learn English. I'm Gloria. Thank you for learning English with me.
Хотите услышать больше таких историй? Это можно сделать через Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify или в любом приложении для подкастов.